Adrian Thrills, cub reporter with New Musical Express, on my way up from London to Coventry, home of the Rudies. The assignment, to check out the Two Tone organisation, the fastest growing independent record label in the country. Since releasing their first record last summer, all 8 Two Tone singles have been hits. And all this is happening in Coventry, of all places. First stop, the old Railway Goods office, now Horizon Studios, where one of the Two Tone bands, The Selector, are recording a single.
Kind of recycle, okay?
Personally, I was born in Jamaica and sort of came over to England when I was about 11 or so. So I had that part of the scar feel in me.
What way is the scar that you play now different from the scar of the 60s now?
Well, the difference is that this is a 1980 song, which we have the old scar rhythm, and we have reggae, we have blues, and there's a bit of funk, and of course we have Janil playing this rock Rock guitar on top of all that, which makes the whole thing
like
so
mixture,
dynamic.
It's mixture of all different, the cultures totally clashing and mixing up.
Yeah.
Because the selector, you know, have come up so quickly, like from nowhere.
Yeah.
I think a lot of people tend to think that you've had it very easy, like, I mean, but I mean, like, you're all playing in bands for a long time before that
and
getting nowhere.
No, the thing is that we weren't sort of getting nowhere. It's sort of people they didn't really interested to come down to Coventry to see what was happening. It's like they hear about Coventry, oh, nothing happens in Coventry.
Yeah.
So they sort of passed. They didn't sort of really look outside London for anything else, you know.
Mm. Some people have said, so I've heard, that ska music presents a very sort of misogynistic, you know, anti-woman aspect. I think me, I partly might be a hangover from like the old Prince Buster records, but I mean, what's your attitude to that?
Yeah, maybe there were a few records around at one time, like, that possibly gave that opinion. One of them is this, I think, Ten Commandments of Man or something, which tends to maybe put down women a little bit, right? But I mean, what we're into is a whole different scene, you know. I mean, let's face it, these guys wouldn't be in a band with a girl if they were really anti-women, wouldn't they, you know?
So you got that sort of taunt from the audience, you know, the old get them off the brigade, you know?
I don't think it would ever happen because that's not what I put across, and it's quite plain to them that's not what I put across. And I mean, I'm not opposed to thumping somebody.
I think one of the things about the whole two-tone thing is it's very much dance music.
Yeah, we're a dance band. We like people to move. We like people to get involved. I mean, when we're on stage, all we put out really is sort of our music and the basic feeling that's behind it. And we can't play unless we move at the same time. And it would appear that the audience can't come and watch us unless they move at the same time.
Yeah.
So that suits us both fine, you know. But, I mean, to say that we're just a dance band, I think, is a bit of a generalisation.
Yeah. Well, no, I wasn't saying that.
No, I
mean,
No, I said that really, didn't I? Yeah. Yeah. Well, we're not just a dance band.
People have said that,
We have things to say as well.
That night, I got a cab downtown to see the specials on their home turf, Tiffany's Dance Hall.
Snow is falling all around. 7 o'clock and the roads are blocked. So I walk downtown. There's no one around. I walk in a bar and immediately I sense danger. You left me girl, if I was some kind of a total stranger. Where did you get that blank expression on your face?
Next morning, I finally tracked the specials down to Two Tone HQ, home of the hits. Next to the poodle parlour, a note said. At last, a chance to meet the board of directors of the fastest growing independent record label in the country.
All right, then. Straight upstairs, all right?
This is where the assault on the nation's airwaves was planned with a unique mix of punk and reggae. Can this be the front office of the do-it-yourself Chartbuster factory?
This is it. This is, I mean, this is great. We've got an office in London that does all the live work and that, but the all the this is where sort of two-tone. This is my desk. I'm showing them around the office. Here we have the checkbooks, the receipts, the contracts. I think this is our Burnie Rhodes contract. No, we've got loads of contracts here. Chrysalis contracts.
Oh, that's Ritz contract.
They're not worth much, not worth a penny. What else have we got? Oh, this is our A&R department. These are the tapes that people send us. As you see, we've been inundated.
All right, my next question.
This is what we listened to, man. This is how the beat came to fame. What else is there in the office?
Things on the
Oh, yeah, and this is the wardrobe department. All second-hand gear, very nice, too. Nice piece of mohair.
All right, Nev, what's a rude boy?
I'm a rude boy. All right, I will answer your question. A rude boy is just a rugged ruffian. Ruffian like I myself, right? They get into trouble. It's just like some young boy over here now, England. They're getting into trouble, breaking into houses and, you know, just vandalizing places and setting places on fire. Well, when they get to about, say, 16, and they're doing little things a bit heavier than that, that's the rude boys, or you could class rude boys in the way of skinheads now, but not the skinheads go around now fighting, but the rude boys, they didn't you have to fight unless it was something to fight about. But the way of dressing was short trousers and short sleeve shirt, or just a shirt, or t-shirt, or whatever. Or jeans, short jeans. Shoes back, I broke down. You know, anything.
Red socks.
Just walking down the street doing bugger all.
I think that's something that's put across in quite a lot of your songs, though, isn't it? Like, to keep out of trouble a bit, you know. What about Message to Rudy? I mean, is there any particular reason that you wanted to cover that?
I mean, a message to you is a message to all the rudies, you know, that they should keep out of trouble, because it don't worth it. In the long run, you just feel it, you know, it's not worth getting into trouble. So it's a message to all the kids who go and cause trouble.
Stop your messing around, oh.
future. Time is red, right up.
This was our inspiration.
Turn the back, turn around.
Jerry,
the history of
you turn
around, Jerry. Turn around, Jerry.
Now, this is a record which Brad gave to me when I shared a house with Brad.
Lent.
He didn't like it. So he gave it to me.
Put it on,
disappeared out of my.
Oh, head. Yes. Why don't we put it on and have a listen?
Yeah, why not?
Is that the right LP? Oh.
That's what the whole thing's been about, really, isn't it? Sort of mixture of various styles, like a bit of punk influence in it.
Yeah. Well, that was Roddy and Terry's contribution, really. On to Terry now.
We were one of the first punk bands in Coventry. Well,
that's when you were in school. Squad, weren't you?
Yeah. We used to support the Wild Boys.
I used to see him dress up with pins and his jacket turned inside out. Right, with a pin and a great big shadow going down there. So I said, what's the game, right? Because I just heard about the punk thing. So it was funny seeing him being a punk, right?
Yeah. You played in soul bands as well, hadn't you?
Yeah, but I hated punk. I just couldn't see the point in it at all.
What sort of brought you like into contact with sort of people like Linval and Neville?
Oh, reggae, because I got into playing reggae a few years ago, and that's from a drummer's point of view, it's a great style, a great rhythm to get involved with, because you can sort of stretch out, be more creative within it, and it also there is a focal point more for the drummer, although the public don't really bother about it so much. You can do more, you know, you can do more with reggae.
What about some of the lyrics? Like, it sort of seems to me that there's two things running through, and one of them is sort of very much anti-violence, I mean, sort of mindless violence, like Message to Rudy and Concrete Jungle, sort of both very against that sort of thing. I mean, what are your feelings about that? Like, some of your gigs, like, you've had some...
Concrete Jungle.
Some trouble, but...
Ruddy. Explain that.
Yeah, what, how did you come to write that?
Yeah. It's about living in a rough part of town, it's all going out and getting beaten up. Nice.
Does that sort of stem from personal experience? Like?
Yeah. You write songs about things you feel yourself or you know, been through.
Go, 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 go,
Of your song has sort of seemed very much against people getting married at a young age. Like, yes. Stupid marriage, too much, too young, you know. I think maybe Roddy should answer that. Are you unmarried?
My wife will kill me.
I mean, what's your attitude to, you know, sort of young people getting married sort of before they're 20 and that?
Well, I just think they should think about it, really. But that particular song was about, was supposed to be humorous. But obviously it wasn't very funny. I don't know, it's just about someone whose girlfriend got married to someone else, so he got jealous and broke a window, ended up in court. And it just said the reason why he did it, because he thought it was stupid to get married young, you know.
But if you get married and have a happy time and a good time, then that's just as good as not getting married and having a happy time. If you can get married and have a happy time, then get married and
I'm happy.
That's what I'm concerned.
Come on, Team Session! Charged with smashing this woman's window. And before I said that to Rude Boy, what am I gonna say, no defense?
I was walking down the street one night when I saw her silhouette in a bathroom light. Her way of life, baby, nothing to hide. When a frosty glass shattered curtains open wide, naked woman.
why you let me tell you to leave. You've been going off to this girl. Please stop. Oh, shut. She left you and married someone else. So you got drunk and smashed up your ex-girlfriend's property. I have come to one conclusion. Hush up! And that is to sentence you to 5 months in prison. And before they take you down to the cell, what have you got to say, your friend?
And she wants him to be something, but she knows he never will. She's got him where she wanted and forgot to take a pill. He thinks that she'll be happy when she's hanging out the nappies. If that's a happy marriage, I'd prefer to be. Where did you get that nice Santa?
Take him away!
That's about it, really.
You didn't quite like that, all
right. Right, shall we have a dance? Right, this is the original of one of the ones that we do.
First of all, I like the music. I'm leaving all they're trying to do. You know, unite the blacks and whites and whatever. Something to follow, the Coventry group. That's something to be proud of, you know, sort of thing.
So they all started off together, all friends together, and they all sort of split off into their different bands. It's a very cosy thing in Coventry, everybody knows what's going on. When you go to other parts of the country, it's catching on now, more down in London. When I used to go home, there's nothing like it at home. It was just all in Coventry.
It's just good.
The lyrics are true, like, you know what I mean?
Yeah, they could happen in real life. You know, sort of.
true. It's not as if it's made up in a fantasy. It's so real.
I don't think they believe in going out and doing your own thing too young. So, I think they believe that you should be free for a good while, you know, in your young days. And don't get yourself into trouble.
Well, Roddy, what do you think of this tape?
Who is it?
It's the Specials.